She's had 8 number one hit records, and she's received countless awards, and she's only 23. We're happy to invite her back here tonight because this was the first show that introduced her to the British public. We're happy she's here tonight. Mariah Carey! They're pleased to see you. I'm pleased to see you.
I'm pleased to be here.
Well, life couldn't be sweeter right now for you at the moment. You've recently got married. Well, not that recently. Was it last year? June. Mm-hmm. And you had, as I said, eight number one. That's brilliant. But about 6 years ago, I mean, things weren't like that for you, were they? Suddenly you're making records. How did that happen?
Right. Okay. Actually, what I did is I've been singing my whole life. My mother was an opera singer. And she sang all types of music, really. But there was always music in my house, and I always loved singing, and I always knew I wanted to be a singer. So from the time I was like 13, I was working in studios with different people. She brought me around, introduced me to different musicians, like older musicians and things. I started out in the studio. So that's like where I learned about the whole process. And then I met someone, a guy named Ben Margulies that I worked with. He became my writing partner. And while I was in high school, I used to drive into Manhattan, work till 3 in the morning and go home and try to get up at 7 o'clock to
go
to school.
How old were you then?
Like 15, 16.
Yeah, wait a minute. You say it all sounds so easy. My writing partner,
okay,
15?
Okay, I met...
You were writing at 15?
Because I've been writing since I was a little girl. You know, I always knew I wanted to be a singer, and I always listened to the radio and said, you know, I could write a song. You know, what's a big deal?
You mentioned your mum was an opera singer, as you say.
Mm-hmm.
Your mum being an opera singer, did she coach you? I mean, you have this extraordinary, I think it's 5 octaves, isn't it? You can.
I don't even know what it is.
Well, that's what they tell me. They also say you've got a whisper register, which a lot of people think I should have. What is a whisper register? Is it technical?
Somebody told me that. I don't even really know what it is. It's supposedly, it's like I do this high thing with my voice, and I don't know if you've heard on any of my records. Please don't ask me to
all
do it now.
I wouldn't like to do it now. Could you do it for us?
But no, it's kind of like, I don't really know how to explain it. It's just a certain part of my voice that I've always had that I can hit certain notes.
Well, it is quite extraordinary. Let's talk about your personal life, not too personal for a moment. Your wedding. Your wedding. I saw the pictures.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you had guests there. How about this for a guest list? Some of the people were Barbara Streisand, Robert De Niro, Bruce Springsteen. Let's get his name right. I don't want him writing to me. Billy Joel. It must have been a lot of... Did you get a lot of toasters? What sort of presents?
Toasters? No.
Must have been just wonderful.
It was a lot of fun, you know. I mean... Tommy has a lot of those friends because of, you know, he's been in this business for a long time, so he has a lot of people that are in this business that are successful, which is great, you know. But to me, the most important people there were like, you know, my family and my friends and the people that mean a lot to you.
Your husband is the boss of the record company that you're recording for. Do you two clash, Tommy Mottola and you? Do you clash over material or career moves or things like that?
I mean,
it's a little early for arguments, but
right.
Well, you can have different points of view on where you should be going and what you should be recording.
The thing is, he's really a musical person. He's not just a record company guy. Like a lot of record company people, they start out selling cars or washing machines or whatever, and then they come into the music business. But he was a singer. He was signed to Epic Records a long time ago. He was a manager. He worked with artists his whole life. So he's really very, very in tune with, you know, where I'm at musically. So we kind of try to have our discussions about music and not so much about marketing or these type of things because it just wouldn't be really... Mm. Good to do that because I have my own definite opinions and he has his own opinions.
Two instincts coming together. It's not exactly a failure. 8 number ones so far. I mean, what else is there? Where do you go from here? 8 number ones, I suppose every record, it's got to be right now, hasn't it?
It's great. I mean, you know, having success is incredible. I've always wanted to do this my whole life, but you can't really base it all on chart success and number ones.
I agree.
Because someday, you know, it can't last forever and... you know, someday I might want to do something that's not such a commercial thing. You know, I might.
Would you ever do movies, maybe? Like Whitney Houston did movies. I'm sure you could do movies. Would you fancy acting?
You know, I'm really focusing on my music right now because that's what I've always wanted to do. You know, some people get into music so they can segue into acting, and it's kind of like a stepping stone for them. This is my life. I love singing. I love music. I'm a producer as well as a musician and,
yeah,
you know,
a writer. Yeah, I noticed that with a producer credit on that.
So a lot of people, you know, women or whoever that do movies, it's kind of easy for them if they don't write their own songs or produce. You know, if that's just not what they're into, it's easier for them to go and do a movie because they're not doing their whole thing. I'm doing my whole album, like from start to finish. So I have to focus on that.
You're going to sing for us now. And this is a Harry Nilsson song,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's called Without You. Mm-hmm. So if you'd like to get on your marks. Okay. Mariah Carey, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Mariah. Mariah Carey singing Without You. Don't go away.